Evet, May.
Hello, good morning, Jay. How are you?
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, lovely to see you.
Lovely, yeah.
Yes, nice. So, like, you are familiar with using the slides, or the handout should be navigated by someone?
Yeah, can you navigate the handout?
Okay, I'm good. Yeah, one moment, I'm just going to download.
Umar is not there.
Umar.
There she is.
She's there. She's downloading my handout because I told her to manipulate the handout.
Yeah, 2 minutes. I'm downloading it and maybe trying it now.
Yeah, yeah. No problem.
No, but that always see how it ruin. You keep your hand out on that side, it's easier to do.
Oh. And then it interferes with my.
You don't have to do anything, she'll be doing it. Rajat Kosh. Rajat is there.
Paroma Sanyal is joined.
Hi, Rajat. Hi, Paroma.
Hi, Jay. Hi, Amrit.
Long time.
How are you?
Fine.
We're both fine.
Yeah, I had not switched on the camera.
Now. How are you, Rajat?
Rajat cannot hear. We cannot hear you.
Shailendra Mohan is there.
That's hello. The
director. Hello.
Oh, it was, yeah. Namaskar, sir. Namaskar. Welcome to this lecture, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, Ilan, sir. Rajat ji, welcome.
Okay. Umas.
Umas.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can. Good. Hello. Ali. Good morning. Good morning, Jay. Good morning, Amrit. So can you see the screen? Good morning, everybody.
Yeah, yeah.
Good morning, Shailendra.
Yeah, good
can you see the screen?
Yes, we can see the screen.
Yes. Because I am using a Mac, otherwise I'll ask my technician to do it. I thought like if we go full screen, is this visible full screen?
This is better.
Is it, but can you enlarge it?
Yes, I will do it as soon as the introduction and other formalities are over. We are not very formal, but informal. Someone will introduce you and after once that introduction part is over, I will make this as full screen.
Okay.
Would that be fine?
भाषा में संरचनात्मकता और तकनीकी पार्ट में उपलब्ध अतिरेक का लाभ उठाया सिस्टम के केंद्र में मानव को रखते हुए हम
सो देयर आर सम पैरेलल प्रोग्राम्स गोइंग ऑन सीआईएल सो दैट इज देयर
श्रुति हैज हेलो श्रुति
हेलो
Hi.
Hello, Shruti.
Hi.
Hi. Can you see me? Yeah. Hi, Shruti.
Hi. A couple of my MA students will join. So
nice to see Shruti. You can, everybody, anybody can join. It's a public lecture.
No, I have this of linguistics, MA linguistics. They'll join.
MA linguistics.
Yeah. Yes,
Subrava, you have not unmuted your mic.
Now can you hear me now?
Yeah, now we can hear you.
Good.
Nice seeing you.
Good to see you. After a long time, quite some time.
Yeah.
Where is Uma Rani?
Yes, she's here.
You can see me now. I was just trying to.
Morning, Papu Swami, where are you?
Good morning, Subhagar Rao.
Good morning.
Namaskaram,
vanakkam, everything.
So, how are you? I'm so happy you are here. I just
I'm
thought
so happy
like
to see you all. It's always like meeting a family.
Yeah. Yes, that's so nice. So we have 2 minutes. Rakesh, are you there? Rakesh is going. Rakesh?
Yes, I am here, my friend.
Can you be on video? Can we see you?
Yes.
Yes. He is Rakesh Cherukodu. He is our Malayalam lecturer in SRLC. I thought it would be a nice honor to have a Malayalam speaker introduce Professor Jai Sheelan.
Okay.
Something and
so, okay, then I will wait.
Nice. So we will record this and afterwards send the lecture to you. I think Amrit also, we have to, others, we will do that. And then maybe you can take 2 months, 3 months to write down your talk. We want to publish this, like we said in the letter. This time we are publishing, like the Golden Jubilee also got delayed for 2 years. Uh-huh. But now we will have 53 lectures are planned. Uh-huh. So,
Uma, you should publish it, but at the same time, increase the circulation, because CL sorry? Publications are not very well known. I'm sorry to
pardon
say
me?
That.
He's
I can't hear you.
I said you have to increase the quantum of circulation of the publication.
Yes, we have plans. Yes, we are doing it. You will see some books will be available. This kind of books will be available online because the lectures are already available online. So it won't be, it will be a non-profit publication. Anyway, we are a non-profit organization, government. So we will see what best we can do.
Then
so
give them
we
for
will
free.
Do that.
Give them for free.
See, I mean, there are so many administrative things I cannot discuss here,
no,
we will
I
do
know
our
that.
Best.
I know the implications. I'm just joking.
Yeah,
saying.
Do...
It's just a joke.
No. I understand. Yeah, now it's 11:30. We'll start on time.
Okay.
So, Pawan Tejas, can you begin recording, Pawan? Record Murthy Hill.
Shri Kumar has joined.
Good morning, sir.
Shri Kumar.
Distinguished Professor K.A. Jai Sheelan, Professor Subbarao, Professor Shailendra Mohan, Professor Amrita Valli, dear colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you all to the lecture number 14 by our star speaker, Professor Jai Sheelan, who needs no introduction to this august audience. Nevertheless, I request Dr. Rakesh Cherukodu to formally introduce the speaker and moderate the session. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Good morning, Anandol. Honorable Director, Central Institute of Indian Languages, Professor Shailendra Mohan, Professor Uma Pappuswamy, Professor Gub Deputy Director and the Coordinator of the 53rd Foundation Lecture Series. My friends and colleagues, I am very happy and privileged to introduce Professor K. Jai Sheelan, who is one of the famous linguists in our country. He is also a former professor and chair of School of Language Sciences at English and Foreign Language University, Hyderabad. He is also a well-known writer and poet of Malayalam literature. He did his degree at Farooq College and MA English at Madras Christian College. He did his MLit at Madras Christian College. He was awarded PhD in English literature from Vishwabharati University, and later he did his MA Linguistics at Lancaster University, UK, and PhD in Linguistics at Simon Fraser University, Canada. His career started as an English teacher, spanned across several institutions. In 1970, he joined as lecturer in Central Institute of English and Foreign Languages, Hyderabad. He retired from the service as a professor from English and Foreign Language University. After his superannuation, he continued his association with IFLU as an adjunct faculty of linguistics. His contribution in linguistics are marked by leaning towards the generative grammar of Noam Chomsky. He has published more than 50 papers in highly reputed journals. And the articles are adverb positions in clause structure, IP, internal focus phrases, anaphores as pronouns, etc. He's the author of many valuable books such as Parametric Studies in Malayalam Syntax, Issues in Chomsky and Linguistics, etc. In 2018, with R. Amradavalli, he has published Dravidian Syntax and Universal Grammar by Oxford University Press. And he has given many lectures in India and abroad. He was the keynote speaker of seminar on educational linguistics at University of Singapore in 1992. He was the visiting scholar of Maison de Sciences, Paris, 1992. He is currently an editorial board member of very important journals like Syntax and Linguistics Analysis. He has presented papers in many seminars in India and abroad, such as the Tokyo University, University of York, University of Taishinghua, University of Geneva, etc. His research interests are theoretical linguistics with a special reference to Dravidian languages in the areas of morphology and syntax. Moreover, he is a very famous and well-known poet in Malayalam literature. He is a recipient of many awards like Vitti Kumaran Award, Anganam Award, etc. Arohanam Vishwarupam, Amayim Kalavum are his famous works. His poems can be described as the micro-travelogue to the deep ecology and human minds, and connecting human sense to the soul of nature. Philosophical insight of his poems are attracted and appreciated by many critics and readers. So I proudly welcome you, sir, for the presentation on Dravidian coordination to issues.
Thank you. Thank you.
You can start, sir.
Yeah. Can I start the lecture?
Sure, sir. You can start now.
Okay.
Tejas, can you please share the presentation?
Yeah. This can be should I start?
Please.
Okay. There are many interesting things about Dravidian coordination. For example, the coordination markers. For example, the marker in Malayalam, which is a conjunction marker. You can say Johnum Billum Peterum. Okay. And you can go on increasing it, Johnum Billum Peterum, Maryum, Susanum, Kateum, etc., etc. So it is like any regular coordination, you can increase it any number of times. And unlike in English, the coordination marker has to be suffixed to every conjunct or disjunct. That is, unlike in English, for example, in English, you can just say John, Bill, and Peter with one and. But in Dravidian languages, you have to have this or this O after every conjunct or disjunct. But that is not what is really interesting about these Dravidian coordination markers. What is really interesting is the fact that while they are, of course, coordination markers, they also function as operators that interact with WH phrases to turn them into quantifiers. They interact with WH phrases to turn them into quantifiers. For example, I have given in the handout, example one is and O acting simply as coordination markers, Johnum, Billum, Peterum, John, Bill, and Peter, or Johno, Billo, Petero, Verum, Johno, Billo, Peter will come. But in two, the and O are functioning as operators. For example, Aaru endu chodichalum avan kodukku. That is, whoever asks for whatever thing, he'll give it. Go to second page of the handout. Uma.
Yes, they're doing that. They just no con modapa, second page.
And in 2A, Uma is acting as an operator that interacts with the two WH phrases in its scope and turns them into quantifiers, like whoever or whatever. And in 2B, you have the sentence, Aruda Veetilo Kallan Kadannu, that is, a thief entered somebody's house. Here, this O, the disjunction marker, interacts with the WH phrase Aru, who, and gives you the meaning somebody, that is an existential quantifier. And in 2C, Mary Vannu O, did Mary come? What this O does is, it turns a statement into a question. It's a question particle. In fact, scroll it a bit. In fact, any WH word in Malayalam, when suffixed with or in the scope of um or o, becomes a quantifier. For example, arum means everybody. Aro means somebody. Entum means everything. Ento means something. Eporum means always. Eporo means at some time. Evideyum, everywhere. Evideyo, somewhere. Scroll down. I had this and O also, also interacts with non-WH phrases to give you quantifiers. For example, Ella Kuttigalum means all the children. Mikya Kuttigalum means most children. Pala Kuttigalum means many children. Go down to the next page. In these forms, the presence of um is obligatory. For example, you cannot say Ella Kuttigal Thottu, all the children failed. That's the intended meaning. But without the sentence is ungrammatical. You have to say Ella Kuttigalum Thottu. And the conjunctive also forms minimizer NPIs. Like, for example, Uru Kuttiyum Vannilla. If with stress on Uru, the number word, this is what's called a negative polarity item. Not a single child came. And it has also been noted that has an additive meaning. For example, John Vannu, Maryum Vannu, means John came, Mary also came. In all these matters, and O is exactly like the Japanese mo and ka. They behave exactly the same. So looking at this data, this puzzle, that the same in one context, it is a coordination marker. In another context, it is it's an operator. And this kind of thing happens only in the Dravidian languages and languages like Japanese and Korean. It does not happen in English. For example, English and or, you cannot use it as an operator. It is simply a coordination marker. So there is this parametric difference problem. Why is coordination so different in English and Dravidian languages? What does the parametric difference consist in? And then we have the unified explanation problem. How do we give a unified explanation of the different uses of and o? That is, Why does it sometimes behave like a coordination marker and sometimes like an operator? Okay, so we go on to the next page. Page 4. We begin by asking the question, what does coordination minimally do? What is the basic thing it does? The basic thing it, the obvious thing it, that it does is it strings together phrases like John, Bill, Peter, Mary, four phrases. You string them together, you concatenate them. Concatenate means connect and make a chain. Catena means chain. Concatenate them. So there is a concatenation operation here, which strings together phrases. And a second thing to note is that the coordinates, that is the phrases John, Bill, Peter, etc., they also bear a small amount of focus that has been noted. Now, when you see focus in a sentence, what does it tell you? It tells you that there must be an operator here that interprets these phrases, that applies to these phrases. And in this particular case, in the case of coordination, what does the operator do? What it does is this. This second operator, it takes each of the coordinates and puts them in a syntactic slot. For example, John and Bill and Peter came. The coordinated phrases are in the subject position. Let us think of the sentence, a basic sentence as X came, with a variable in the position of the subject. So that is, we are talking about an open sentence in the logician's jargon. It's an open sentence with a variable in the position of the subject. And when we interpret this sentence, John and Bill and Peter came, we understand that John came, Bill came, Peter came. We interpret this sentence, the original sentence, as three simple propositions. John came, Bill came, Peter came. And we go from the original sentence to these simple propositions, which can be evaluated for meaning by this operation of substituting the coordinates, each of them serially, in the position of a variable. So, and that is done by something called a choice function. Tanya Reinhart was the person who first proposed the idea of a choice function. A choice function is a function in logic which applies to a set and outputs one member of the set. For example, if you give it a set A, B, C, one set, the choice function applies to it, it outputs A. You apply it again, it can output B, then it apply again, and it can output C. It can go on applying to the set until it picks out each of the members of the set individually. That's what the choice function does. And so what we have said so far is that in coordination, there are two operations. There is a concatenation operation. And for that, there has to be a concatenation operator, which puts together phrases in a string, in a chain. And secondly, there is a choice function or substitution operation, an operation which takes the members of the set and substitutes them in the position of a variable serially. That is the a choice function operator. So there are two operators, a concatenation operator and a choice function operator. Now, we come to our explanation of the parametric difference problem. Our first ancillary proposal is this. The coordination markers on the coordinates, like for example, and John and Bill and Peter, the coordination marker, Johnum, Billum, Peterum. The coordination markers are copies of the operators. And so they are not really the operators, they are copies of the operators. Operator is generated in the C position and in the composition, along with all other things that go into the comp area. So the operators are there, its copies are on the coordinates. And the most important proposal which I'm going to make is that languages lexically realize either one of the two operators, but not both. That is, it's a kind of economy in languages. So there are two operators. There is a concatenation operator and a choice function operator. And a language chooses to lexicalize, so that is to give phonetic form to one of the operators and the other operator is silent. It is an economy principle in languages. So we said that there are two operators in coordination, a choice function operator and a concatenation operator. If the coordination markers are copies, we should expect to see two coordination markers with each coordinate. But we see only one, and that is because the other operator is silent in the language. And my claim is that English and or, they are copies of the concatenation operator, and the choice function operator is silent in this language. And in languages like the Dravidian languages, Japanese, Korean, etc., these are the coordination markers of copies of the choice function operator or the substitution operator, and the concatenation operator has no lexical realization in the language. And we go on to the structure that we assume for English and Malayalam coordination is shown the next page, that is, 9. See, in English, the concatenation operator has lexical realization and the choice function operator is null. So get and XP. In Malayalam, the concatenation operator is silent and the choice function operator is expressed, So we get Johnum. So those are the two structures. Note that we are treating section 2.3. Thank you. We are treating English coordination exactly like Malayalam coordination or Dravidian coordination in general. They are all treated as polysynthetic. That is, we generate John, Bill, and Peter as underlyingly being and John, and Bill, and Peter. And for us in our system, it is not the concatenator, it is only a copy of the operator. The operator itself is concatenation operator, is in the C domain, and the copies are on the And concatenation is done by the concatenation operator, not by the AND. Because treating, what logicians have done is they have treated the coordination marker AND, coordination AND, as itself the operator. And they have analogized it to the Boolean operator of Boolean operators of conjunction and disjunction, or union and intersection. And treating it like that creates a lot of problems, as Rajesh Bhatt would tell you, because in his paper he had a lot of problem with this. So yeah, go on. Yeah, okay, stop there. Now we said that there are two operators, a concatenation operator and the choice function operator in this thing. There is a difference between these two operators. The one is that the concatenation operator is a thing which sequences phrases, collects phrases and sequences them, like A and B and C and D and E, etc. Sequences phrases. Now, since it's a sequencer, it needs to apply to overt elements of a set of more than one element. You cannot sequence a set if it has got only one member. It has to have at least two members. So it has to have overt elements to sequence. On the other hand, the choice function operator has that also needs to have a set of greater cardinality than one. That is, more members than one, because you cannot choose if there is only one member. But the difference is that the choice function operator can apply to a set, provided it has got more than one member. But the set need not be spelled out. So the choice function operator can apply to what is overtly a single element if it signifies a set of greater number than one. For example, a WH phrase. A WH phrase, we know, is signifies a variable. Who came? We don't know the identity of the who. But the WH phrase, the variable, can be interpreted as the universal set. And therefore, when or O applies to it, it can treat it as the universal set and give you the universal quantifier with the meaning of everybody, or the universal disjunction, like Arum. Why does Arum means everybody? Because Aru is a WH word which signifies a variable, and is the choice function which interprets this to apply to the whole universal set. And the same way, Aru. So the difference between why we have this, the Dravidian coordination markers have this double life, as I said, sometimes behaving exactly like simple coordination markers, and sometimes behaving as operators, is that when you see or O on the coordinates, like in Johnum, Billum, Peterum, they are copies of the operator. Whereas when you see this in a quantifier, as part of a quantifier, then it is a quantifier itself. So that is how you get this impression that there's a double life for these operators. Okay, next page. Structure of polysyndetic coordination. This is the new stuff I have added for this talk, because the other stuff is already been published in a 2016 paper. The structure of by polysynthetic coordination, I mean that like Dravidian coordination, that when there is the coordination marker is attached to every conjunct or disjunct, like Johnum, Billum, Peterum. Whereas in English, it looks as if you can get by with just one and, John, Bill, and Peter. And when work began in generative linguistics on coordination, the paradigm case of coordination was taken to be English. That was a mistake we made. The paradigm case was taken to be English, and the paradigm case of coordination was taken to be the coordination of two phrases, like in John and Bill. John and Bill. In this phrase, it is easy to analyze this "and" as the connector, as the element that concatenates elements. And all the work in generative linguistics, both the syntax and the semantics of coordination, is premised on this assumption. In semantics, "and" is taken to be a Boolean operator. The Boolean operators, union and intersection, they concatenate elements pairwise. And most work on coordination in generative semantics is based on this assumption. In X-bar syntax, go down 10, what they did was they took "and" as the head of a coordination phrase. And for John and Bill, for example, will be taken to represent that is 10 in your example, 10 in your handout. John and Bill will have, "and" will be the head of the phrase, and John will be the specifier, and Bill will be the complement. But there are problems even in European languages. Like, for example, Cain pointed out in 1994, his volume, that in French, you can get a coordination marker. "Et" in French means "and." Even with the first conjunct, for example, you can say, "Jean connaît et Paul et Michel." John knows and Paul and Michael. Now, if the element "et," that is "and," is a connector, what is the first "et" doing there? "Et Paul," what is it doing there? So it is not a connector, even in European languages. Because, and in, you know that in Dravidian, we can get a coordination marker with every conjunct or disjunct. Okay, go on to the next page. And the problem becomes more complex when we have more than two conjuncts. Where do we put the third conjunct, fourth conjunct, fifth conjunct, etc.? So, but in our system, a pair is no more basic to coordination than say a triple or a quadruple. We can have any number, because for us, concatenation is not done by the and. Concatenation is done by the coordination, by the operator, which is in C. And that concatenation operator can concatenate any number of phrases at one go. Can concatenate 2, 3, 4, any number. Okay, go down in the handout. For example 12, Cain gave the analysis 12a, et Paul, et Michel, where, but this is not a very intuitive structure, because we would like the two phrases, Paul and Michel, to have the same relation to the concatenation marker. What the structure we want is given in 12b, et Paul, et Michel. And we want to extend it to et Paul, et Michel, et Marie. And we need more structure than is shown in 12c, because we need to integrate this into X bar syntax, which is binary branching. And also, there are inter se C command relations within the coordinated phrase. For example, an earlier phrase, C commands a later phrase. This is 13a, for example. I saw him and John's wife at the party. Him and John cannot be coreferential because of a condition C violation. So there is a C command relation there. So go on to the next page. The coordination, the phrases have to be, have no relation to selectional relation between these phrases. Okay? They are just phrases which fill the same syntactic slot in coordination. For example, there is a famous example by in Dickens. She went home in tears and a sedan chair. Okay. In tears and a sedan chair. Tears and sedan chair have nothing to do with each other. Their only relation is that they fill the same syntactic slot. So what I'm trying to say is that whatever connects these phrases in a binary branching structure with the appropriate C command relations, that head must be a null head with no meaning and no phonetic content. So we can build this up like this. Take the last phrase and the generate a null head. Yeah, and that's given in 14. XPN, that's the last phrase. And you generate a head and merge the next phrase in the sequence, XP2, in the specified position. Then use that as the anchor and build further. So you get a structure like that in this thing. Okay. The relation of the coordination markers to the operators is very interesting. That is, I said that the coordination markers are copies. They're simply copies. They are not operators. They are semantically inert. Their only function is to flag a constituent for the attention of the operator. It's like saying, haha, I'm here. Okay? The focus also does the same thing. It draws the attention of the operator. The operator is in the C position. And the coordinates, which can be multiple, they need to come to the attention of the operator. So there is this copy of the operator on the coordinate, and also there is focus. Let us go down, I think. Yeah. And treating the coordination markers as operators has done a lot of mischief in the semantics of coordination. Because take a sentence like John vannu, Maryum vannu. John came, Mary also came. But our analysis is that the here is simply a copy and not the operator. But the copy indicates the presence of the operator in the C domain. Because you cannot have a copy unless there is the operator in the C domain. And the operator in the C domain has the semantic requirement that it needs a set of greater cardinality than one. That is, it has to have a set of greater number than one. And therefore, this situation induces the presupposition that there must be also, when you say Maryum vannu, it induces the presupposition that there must be another element which also must be in the predicate of came. John came, Mary also came. In English, we translate it as also. And so it is when you wrongly analyze this as the operator, it creates a lot of problem in the semantics of, I won't go into it because Japanese semantics of coordination is messed up by these kinds of mistakes. Go on to the next section. I think I have. Yes, the distributivity of We said that the Malayalam that is a Dravidian is a choice function operator. A choice function operator picks out elements from within a set, one by one. And because of this, any form, complex form, which has got this in it, must have a distributive meaning. That is, what I mean is, it cannot be a collective meaning, but a distributive meaning. Let me illustrate this with English all. Suppose you have the house, you have bought a piano, and the piano is a very heavy object, and it has been delivered in the drawing room, and you have to carry it upstairs, and you get together a number of strong young people to carry it there. And they generally would hold it at one end, each one at one end, and together they'll carry it upstairs. So you can say in this context to describe this event, the young man carried the piano upstairs. The natural interpretation is that they all joined together and carried it upstairs. But suppose instead I say, all the young men carried the piano upstairs. This has the wrong meaning, because it means that each one of the young men carried the piano upstairs, which is impossible. All the young men, English all, is a distributive element. Exactly like the of Malayalam is a distributive element. For example, in 15A, anybody who's lived in Kerala will know what a pattayam is. Pattayam is the very heavy, large box, wooden box, in which paddy is stored after harvesting. And it is so heavy, if you have to lift it, you have to have 20 people to lift it. Okay? So, when you say a thing like 15A, Ella kuttigalum pattayam pokki, that is only the meaning. Instead of saying kuttigal, let us have chirupakar, young men. Ella chirupakarum pattayam pokki. That means every one of them lifted it. It has only the distributive meaning. Or if you say moon chirupakarum or moon kuttigalum pattayam pokki. All the three children, all the three young men lifted the rice bin. That means that each of them individually lifted it, which is an impossible thing. Whereas if you have a sentence without chila kuttigal pattayam pokki, some children or some young men lifted the rice bin, you would naturally interpret it as collective, not as distributive. Or 16B, moonu kuttigal pattayam pokki. Three young men lifted the rice bin. Go on to the next page. And the interesting thing is that when a distributive operator applies to a set, there is a semantic implication that the set is definite. So it induces a definiteness meaning on the set. Ella kuttigalum, that is universal set. Moonu kuttigalum pattayam pokki, all the three children. Whereas if I say moonu kuttigal pattayam pokki, does not mean that there were only three children in the context. There could be 100 children, but three of them lifted it. So the distributive operator always induces the meaning of of definiteness. Yeah, that's the talk. Then it comes to the conclusion. Thank you. Yeah. I can take questions.
Sir, kaiyirunnu sir. കഴിഞ്ഞായിരുന്നോ സാർ? സാർ വളരെ വളരെ നന്ദി, വളരെ നന്ദിയുണ്ട്. വളരെ ആഴമേറിയ നിരീക്ഷണമാണ് സാർ അവതരിപ്പിച്ചത്. എനിവേ, താങ്ക് യു സാർ ഫോർ യുവർ തോട്ട് പ്രൊവോക്കിംഗ് ലെക്ചർ ഓൺ ദി വീഡിയോ കോർഡിനേഷൻ. നൗ ദി സെഷൻ ഈസ് ഓപ്പൺ ഫോർ ഡിസ്കഷൻ.
താങ്ക് യു. Have I been very fast or unclear?
No, it was wonderful to listen to you as always. Thank you so much. So it's now like there are many people in the Google Meet and also YouTube. So Rakesh will moderate the session and take the questions. It's an interesting topic from Dravidian perspective. So please, Rakesh, you can moderate.
Paroma wants to ask a question.
Yeah. So if others are not asking, I had a couple of questions. So the first one is, so these so similar to the distributive operator and this the similar kind of operator, you also had another paper on reduplication, which was also showing an operator which was doing similar kinds of things, which also had the plural and the distributivity and this. So how do these, the and the reduplication operator, so how do they interact and what's the interaction like in Malayalam?
Okay, Baroma. You are thinking about my joint paper with Rahul.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's Rahul Balusu and K. Ajayashiru joint paper that studied distributivity. Yeah. And my part of that paper described the behavior of the reduplicated pronoun, avaravar.
Mm-hmm.
That is, avaravar means they. And that has a distributive meaning. For example, ella kuttigalum avaravarude veetilekku poi. All the children went to their respective homes. Okay? And ella kuttigalum avaravarude veetilekku poi. There is a condition on the set which is distributed over, that is the kuttigal, ella kuttigalum. That set has to be definite. For example, ella kuttigalum veetilekku poi, you can say, or you can say moonu kuttigalum veetilekku poi, all the three children went home. But you cannot say, this is the interesting thing, chila kuttigal avaravarude veetilekku poi, you cannot say. Chila kuttigal avaravarude veetilekku poi, it's a really bad sentence. That is, chila means some.
Okay.
Chila means some. So you can say all the children went to their respective homes. All the three children went to their respective homes. But some children went to their respective homes. It is bad even in English.
Yeah.
Okay, some children went to their respective homes. You cannot say it. Because when you want to distribute it, there's a semantic requirement that first you have to limit the set. There has to be a definite set. That is why some children went to their respective homes is bad in English.
Question is about homes.
We
need homes.
No. So, what Paroma is worrying about is there is distributivity there, there is distributivity here.
Yes, and the distributive operator is on the
screen. Whom is not always have to be present for distributivity. There are other elements also, forms also, which induce distributivity, like this however, reduplicated pronouns. Yeah.
Yeah, the second thing I was worrying about is this the operator is on the sea. Now, and you have a copy of it in the wherever it surfaces on the focused element. Now, if there is a distributivity in a sentence, so the interaction part, so in the example that you get with in the all the children went to their respective home, ella kuttigalum. So that sentence, avaravar poi. So that sentence, there is only one operator which is at the C, but you are looking at two different places where you are finding the. So what is there any restrictions on where the copy can, when the copy surfaces, and or is it a even without the if you have that sentence will have the same kind of distributive meaning?
That's an interesting question. That is what you're saying is this.
You can say kuttigal avaravarude.
Kuttigal avaravarude veetilekku poi.
Yeah, that's what Amrit said.
Kuttigal avaravarude veetilekku.
Yeah.
There, avaravar itself is the distributor.
Yeah, but is becoming optional and it's not necessarily.
No, with avaravar, is not obligatory.
It's not obligatory.
No. The what you are worrying about is if there is a distributive operator in the.
Is there one distributive operator? Is there two sources of. So because it's the same position at the C that you are having that.
That's also similar to WH questions. Now something, there's some term for it where you, there's one operator which binds many WH.
Yes, that is, for example, one can bind several WH phrases.
I wondered who. Mm-hmm.
There is one and you get two WH phrases.
Sentence was who bought what where.
Yeah, yeah, that is. Mm-hmm. There is one question operator which applies to three WH phrases there. Yeah. I wonder who bought what where.
Mm-hmm. Which is very different from the coordination context where you'll need to have the copy in all the places.
Yes, the copy has to be, if it is on the coordinates, they have to, the on the coordinates is a copy. But there is also which is not a copy, for example, arum. Arum. That's not a copy, that is the operator itself. Yeah, I think that is the thing.
Yeah, okay, okay.
And in that case, it is not in the C domain.
Mm-hmm.
The operator is not in the C domain, the operator is on the phrase. In fact, when I presented it in Taiwan, Richie Kane asked me, why can't the copy this thing, arum, that also the operator can be in the C domain. Mm. This can also be a copy. Mm. The trouble with that, I told him, it's all in the paper. Okay. My answer and Richie's question. The answer was, sometimes you get two WH phrases with one operator.
Mm-hmm.
Like, ar endu paranjalim. Whoever says whatever. There is two WH phrases, ar endu. There is only one. Mm-hmm. And for that, has to be, it behaves like an operator that binds several variables, which can happen in the semantics of WH phrases. Like, for example, I wonder what, who, what, bought, who bought what. Okay? So that is typically the behavior of an operator and not that of a copy. That was my answer to Rishiki.
Did you also think about what is the copy copy mechanism that you have to for the copy to surface on the focused elements? Because is it like the earlier case kind of thing?
Good question. Good question, Paroma. I have a largish footnote in the paper I published.
Mm-hmm.
It talks about how the copy comes about. Because if the operator is in the C domain and the coordinates are in different places within the sentence, one would think that you need to copy from the operator down here. And we don't want downward copying. Mm-hmm. Downward operations we don't want.
Mm-hmm.
And so my suggestion was that when the operators are in the numeration, while you're putting together the sentence, you have put together the phrases to be coordinated. And at some point, a copy of this, the operator in the enumeration, its copy is attached to each coordinate. And finally, when the sentence is complete, the operator itself is merged in the C domain. In this way, you can avoid downward copy.
Because they're generating each coordinate separately.
Yes, each coordinate is generated separately. Stands to reason. Then, and as you are putting it together, you take the operator in the numeration and attach a copy to it. There are two operators, you attach two copies to each coordinate. And then at the end, you merge the operators from the numeration into the zero.
So there is some operation that happens within the numeration.
At the point of merge, there is an operation. That's an operation of merge.
Hmm.
That is, there are phrases are put together,
mm-hmm.
Done by merge, and then along with that,
yeah,
the operator copies, whichever the operators themselves are in the enumeration, their copies are also merged. It is part of the merge operation.
Yeah, and right. merge is merging phrases.
Not, yeah.
Not
yeah, merge is, of course, dealing with sometimes simple lexical items, sometimes phrases. There is no problem.
Okay. Thanks.
So any other questions or suggestions, please?
Yes, Uma. Uma has a question.
Yes, I was just waiting for others to ask. Yeah, number one, it was a fantastic talk. I was wondering whether the claims you have made for Malayalam, can it be generalized for Tamil, Telugu, and Kannada as well?
Oh, yes, absolutely.
So
in Tamil also, the coordination marker is Uma.
Ramana. Yes, but I was just in, yeah. How about the lexical coordination? I do not know about Malayalam. In Tamil, we can say something like Ramanu, Kumaru, Matrum, Raviyo, Anuvo, Varatum. So we are having a combination of these markers in one structure. The first one, we have a nominal coordination, and then you're giving a choice, like then again you're having the lexical coordinator matrum.
Yeah, that is only also John and Bill
possible,
and others. As in English, John and yes. Bill and others. There is no problem. That is also a coordinate.
And also you have that and
matrum.
The same way as
and you can coordinate not only noun phrases, you can coordinate
your verbal coordination, yeah.
Yes, Ramanam, Krishnanam, Mattam, Nadanam, Odiyam, Poi.
Yeah, we can say that.
Yeah,
so that is, are there any, when you are serializing these verbs, do you have...
Verbs can be serialized. In fact...
For the position.
Not only nouns, verbs can be coordinated. Adjectives can be coordinated with some provisos. Okay.
Is there any flexible? Is there any order of coordination within the phrase, or can it be? Is it more flexible?
The order seems to be arbitrary. Arbitrary.
Mm-hmm.
Arbitrary.
Okay.
You can say Ramanam, Krishnanam, Govindanam, or you can say Govindanam,
or you can say Govindanam, Ramanam.
So the, okay. There is no.
So the, there is no.
The pragma, what you are probably saying, Amrit says,
there is a
Yes, that is a matter of what do you call it? It is a conversational principle. That is when he said
Yeah, this is addressed by Ruth Gibson really long ago.
Yes.
Because we had a similar construction like what you were saying about when you were talking after your talk, the example you gave. I have a similar construction in Tamil. I was wondering whether, for example, yella kuttigalum or yella kulandigalum in Tamil, yella kulandigalum avar avaroda ammavayo appavayo alaitthu kondu varano. So you have this distribution, like again the have the womb and also you have how does this work?
Yes, correct.
That's possible for you as well, right?
Oh yes.
Okay.
Both are distributives. Ella kutti kuttigalum.
Thank you.
So any other questions, please?
I think that is the sum of questions.
Yeah, so anybody else, any like Professor Subbarao and others are here? Any questions from you, Professor Subbarao?
Nothing in specific, Uma. Nothing, Jay.
Telugu la etla, same. Narustunda.
Exactly. Well, the example you gave, it works for Telugu also.
Yes. It works with
all the four, maybe.
Yes, as I said to Uma, it works for all Gibedian languages. The Um might be U in Telugu, yeah.
Ooh. Andaru vacharu.
And in Tamil it is Uma, I think.
Yes.
And in Kannada it is ooh. Kannada and Telugu it is ooh.
We go together, yeah.
Yeah. There is a ooh sound with a nasalization.
No, not ours. There's no nasalization. Andaru.
No. There's no nasalization.
No nasalization. Okay. We lost the whom, them somehow.
Yeah.
He still doesn't know his Kannada.
I remember talking about this with Rahul about this Telugu form. Who?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it was a wonderful talk. Of course, I need to think more.
I will say, have you got the handout?
We will distribute it. If anyone is interested, of course, they will distribute your handout.
I would like to have a...
Yeah, they will send that.
I'll send it to...
Yes. Okay, thanks.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah. All right. So, thank you so much, Professor Jayashilan. It was indeed a great pleasure to have you with us today, because we missed you earlier when we invited Amrit. The same time we sent the email in early July, somehow you did not receive the email, but so glad we could reschedule your date, and it's always nice to listen to great scholars like you, because I still remember your guidance you gave to me when I was working on LFG. So I'm remembering those days, how much you had inspired us as students, and you still inspire many of us. So thank you for your wonderful talk and for taking time off from your work and to be with us. Like Rakesh said earlier, Professor Jayashilan is not just a linguist, he's a well-known poet in Malayalam. Some of us may not know that, but I just wanted to reiterate that. So he's an awardee of this V.T. Kumaran Foundation awardee, inaugural awardee. That's indeed something nice. I never knew the poetic side of you. So maybe I think this, when you're talking about, I don't know whether you use wombs more in your poetry, because in Tamil songs, we do have womb in many ways, like Engeyum, Yepodum, Sandosham. So many, like Kannadasan songs, lyrics, if you see, poetry, a lot of coordination is used. I do not know about your own poetry.
What is your mother tongue?
I'm sure.
What is your mother tongue?
Sorry?
What is your mother tongue?
It's a complicated question. My native tongue, I don't subscribe to the thought of mother tongue. I know it's being recorded. My native tongue is Telugu. My ethnic tongue is the Telugu. And since I'm now in Mysore, I speak Kannada as well. So I'm a Dravidian, no doubt. So so that is there. But I'm a native speaker of Tamil. So because I was born and brought up in Tamil Nadu, Coimbatore. So that is there, but it's interesting to see, like, of course, always fascinated by Malayalam, because being in Coimbatore, bordering Kerala, Palakkad, so I exposed to Tamil from the childhood, Malayalam from the childhood as well. So it's nice to listen to you talking about these things, and of course, I am sure people will benefit from your handouts. We will distribute that, and waiting for your paper as well. So once again, I thank you on behalf of my institute and on behalf of the director, my colleagues, and everybody present here. I also hear the topic was double coordination, and here this session was also double coordinated by Rakesh Cherukodu and Prem Kumar. Like, thanks Rakesh for introducing and moderating the session, and Prem for beautifully navigating the handout section by section so that the audience were not irritated and we could follow the lecture very wonderfully. I also thank senior professors like Professor Subbarao, Professor Amrithavalli, and many others. I cannot name each and everyone here for being with us today, and enriching this session by your interactions and by your presence as well, because it's very important that people are there in the Google Meet. And I'm sure, like, we have noticed that after the session is over, we see that many people visit our YouTube links, and in some of the lectures have crossed like 800 views, or it's easily 400, 500 views for each of the lectures. So we will also send it to, we have plans to send it across to different linguistic departments, so that if people are having such topics in their syllabus, the students can benefit afterwards. Because the whole purpose of doing these lectures is not only to commemorate the Foundation Day of CIL, but also to cater to the linguistic needs of the young people, the students especially. That's the reason we wanted great scholars to come and share their experience working on different aspects of languages and linguistics with us. Thank you once again.
Thank you for inviting me.
Thank you.
Pleasure interacting with so many friends.
A great choice of the topic and a great choice of the speaker.
Thank you.
That's what I wrote.
We are waiting to hear yours. Pardon me, we are waiting for your talk.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, when is your talk?
Links across.
Yeah.
Thank you, everybody. It's nice to see you.
So many.
Yes, that would be fantastic. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. Bye.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye bye, Jay. Bye bye, Amrit.
Bye
bye.
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 Hello.
Yes, please, but your voice is breaking.
I was wondering how we could get a copy of the handout of today's seminar.
Okay, so we will make the handout available on CIL Facebook link or something so that anyone can download. All right.
So, yes, ma'am. Thank you.
So please visit our website, CIL website. Somewhere we will put the link to the handout along with the talk. Somewhere you will find it. If not, you can write to us. All right. Okay. Okay, thank you everybody again. Bye.